This is Eddie Jackson.
And Scott Rockenfield of Queensryche, and you're watching WAAF, Real Rock TV.
Whoa, we're in the ozone. Hi, I'm John Osterlin.
And I'm Drew Bledsoe. Welcome to another edition of Oh, I guess it's not going to work. Oh, well. Hope he has Anthony, and Hillman has LB, Kevin, and Chris. I figured Drew and I could get anyway. Welcome to another edition of WAAF, Real Rock Television. Big week in store this week. Lots of action-packed performances and fun. For instance, Mighty Joe Plum, live in the Ozone Cafe, interview and jamming with them. Then we're going to go over to Guitar Center in Natick, where they did a live in-store. We'll also go to the Middle East in Cambridge and hear from those wild Swedish women, Drain STH, when they opened for Corrosion of Conformity. Hillman was off last week in the morning, so we had five different disc jockeys fill his shoes, and we're going to show you some of the best of that, including New England Revolution star Lexi Lawless, and state treasurer, and hopefully, well, at least for his sake, future governor Joe Malone, filling in for the Hillman. Hillman better watch out for his job. He better not take too many vacations anymore. And finally, we'll go over to Great Woods, the opening for Queensryche. We had that contest. We had 500 tapes and CDs, and a band called Dirty Larry ended up winning. So we're going to check out all of that. It's Real Rock TV. Stay right where you are. It's WAF.
Born here, man, so I go, you know, half of my family's still up here. And
oh, really?
Yeah.
Are they going to go to Guitar Center tonight?
Yeah, they're coming out, man.
Jeez, they better. if they don't, why would anybody else
go?
Jesus, the guy's family's not going to go. Why should I show up?
Yeah, if they're listening, hey, man.
Oh, I thought you were just being smart by wearing the Boston Bruins Cam Neely jersey, you know? I mean, I thought you figured you're from somewhere else and you're like, well, I'm coming to Boston. Obviously. You're smart.
I figured you might think that, but I like baseball, man.
Funny, you think that's very smart is he didn't wear a Boston Red Sox jersey because people would probably be throwing stuff at him.
I'm not that crazy, man.
So where are the rest of you guys from? Where'd you hook up? Where'd you meet? Where'd Mighty Joe Plum become a band?
Tampa, Florida.
Yeah.
Sunny Tampa, Florida.
Sunny and hot Tampa, Florida.
You still live down there now?
Yeah. We're still down there in the Florida area.
Cool, man.
Yeah.
So tonight, Natick, it's Guitar Center, it's Mighty Joe Plum, it's a free show, all ages, if you're two, you can go. And if you want to go see a real good rock band, let's get a taste of it now. It's Mighty Joe Plum live in the Ozone Cafe on WAA.
Up a stone wall, wind blew, he flew into a free fall, and he caught himself again on the way down, and then he disappeared behind a drain pipe. What if I fell 15 stories? What if my weight wasn't enough to kill me? What if I were sticky enough to walk the ceiling well? I imagine myself living in the groove, in and out of in between. I need some room to move, but I know I'm too big to fit myself between. Footsteps in concrete. What if I fell 15 stories? What if my weight wasn't enough to kill me? What if I were sticky enough to walk the ceiling well? Mm-hmm. afraid of falling, be trapped underneath, and it's crushing me. I can't shed my skin, or it's crushing me, and I'm slipping, yeah, well, it's crushing me. And I can't shed my skin, well, it's crushing me. What if my weight was
I think it was great. It was really fun. It was so many bands that, you know, that we liked, that we played with. And that was a lot of fun. We even had Dimebag up on stage one night. That was great.
It was great. I mean, get a chance to open up for Ozzy Osbourne and Black Sabbath. I mean, it's an honor.
Yeah.
We grew up with Sabbath and stuff like that. So that was really cool. Endless party for 5 weeks with all these bands. We had a great time. Played in front of a lot of people.
They were all great.
The great thing was, though, that we played twice a day. That was pretty cool. That we played two 20-minute sets, so that was cool.
Is that hard?
Yeah, some days it was hard. Especially when you had to start too early. It was hard for me to sing early in the morning.
Let's rip that off.
I think you learn a lot. I think so.
Yeah, I think so too.
We don't write when we're on the road, but you get inspired, so I think when we go back to write the next album, we will have lots inside
of us.
We're going to go back to Sweden
It's easier for us to be at home, you know, to concentrate. To concentrate.
Nothing happens in Stockholm anyway, so you can really concentrate on the songwriting.
Thank you.
WAAF's
Real Rock TV. We'll be right back.
You're sitting at a stoplight in the testosterone-injected sports car of your dreams when you spot a beautiful buxom brunette. Suddenly, your eyes meet hers. You wait for the right moment to unleash a fury of sound from your new Jensen Nitro Series car speakers. And in an instant...
Just call me an angel of the morning.
And it's at that time you decide never to let your sister drive your car again. The new Jensen Nitro Series. Listen, if it's too loud, you're too old.
You're watching an ice-cold beer being poured into a chilled glass at Ebenezer's in Framingham. We had to pour 174 beers to make this commercial. Doesn't that make you feel a little guilty? I mean, what kind of person sits there and watches an ice-cold beer when they could be drinking one? At Ebenezer's Restaurant and Bar on Route 135 in Framingham. Ebenezer's. We know what you want.
Relax. It's Pat. WAAF's Real Rock TV.
What do you mean, do I know if any of the women in Drain are single? Just because we play them, I don't know anything about their personal life. Leave me alone. Jesus. These people. All right, welcome back to Real Rock TV. Now, this is fun because one of our weekend disc jockeys, Dave Lee, one of his favorite bands of all time is Queensryche, and when he was asked to go talk to him down at Grey Woods, he was so psyched. Let's go check in with them right now.
Hey, it's Dave Lee again. We're here at Mansfield with a couple members of the band, Queensryche. I have with me Scott.
Hello.
Oh, you have a microphone.
Yeah, we do.
That's right.
Oh, Ed, you're doing good. And Eddie.
Chris is singing on at least one track in the new CD. Is this something that's going to continue in the future, or is this just an experimental thing for you guys, or do you have any ideas as to what you're going to do in the future with that kind of thing?
You know, we're always just kind of looking for... you know, trying to do things that we haven't done before, and the example of what you're talking about with Chris singing All I Want was just, you know, he came up with an idea for a song and had a vocal thing for it, actually a demo that he brought in and presented to us, and we liked it so much we just let him do it. So, you know, we're trying to do things that we haven't done before, and it was one direction we have never headed, so Jeff was very, you know, understanding and said, hey, cool, you did a good job, you know, why don't you go ahead and sing the song, and I'll get done early and take a couple weeks off.
We never really know what we're going to do next. You know, we just focus on the tour, and once we're done touring, we start, you know, we'll take a little break and then start working on some new material. But we actually start working on material as we're touring. But once we get home, you know, we just get together and start working on some ideas. But whatever happens, happens. We just don't really know where we're going to go from here.
I think a lot of us here actually got to see the laser show you had at the Boston Museum of Science. I was there, my wife was there, Ian was there. And Ian brought up a good point.
Ian, what was that?
Well, my point was that every time I hear your music now, I think of the laser show. You know, it pops right into my head as I hear it on the radio. That's a pretty dramatic effect. Do you find that the visuals coincide with your music? Are you very conscious of how you portray your music visually?
It's a big part of what we do. Yeah, I think, you know, musically we've always tried to do things in a visual way and present our material that way on an album, so to speak, and I think live, you know, we like to add that visual candy with what we do live and videos and you know, everything with the band. We're kind of a hands-on type of band. Want to, you know, try to incorporate as many different aspects of multimedia.
What about CD-ROMs? I know you've released one CD-ROM. You planning on doing more to coincide with future releases?
I thought you were going to ask me where my game piece is.
I keep telling you, I got everybody else's, I can't find yours. You know, and I've never played the game, so I couldn't tell
I you. Truthfully couldn't tell you either.
It's hard to say right now, but who knows? We might surprise you with another CD-ROM game. But the first one was really fun, and it'd be nice to do another one.
It was a long process. It took 2 years for us to put that together, so... You know, it was the right type of album to do it with, and the making of the record was a part of, you know, the ROM is a two-disc set with the make. One of the discs is you go into a log cabin, it's all animated, and you can see how we made the record and find documentary footage. Then you can go outside the cabin on the other disc and kind of play the game, so to speak, of the forest. And that record and that approach to making the album lent itself well to doing a CD-ROM, but it was a long process. I'm not too sure we're ready to do another one right now at this point, but who knows, that could change.
Okay, well, I don't want to take up any more time of your time, but thanks for coming by.
Yeah, thank you.
It's been a
thank
great
you.
Pleasure, and I look forward to seeing the show tonight.
And now, Alexi Lawless breaks another radio guest host boundary by singing and playing the guitar with his feet on WAAF.
Someone found an acoustic guitar in the back, and in keeping with the 80s theme that we've established here, I'm going to play a little... Motley Crue, acoustically.
Nice. Yeah!
Lightning. I want everybody out there to grab their hairspray, all right, grab their lighters, and think about Home Sweet Home.
You know I'm a dreamer, but my heart's a go. I run away high, so I wouldn't come home, no. When things went right, doesn't mean you're always wrong. Just take this song, and you'll never be left all alone. Sing to your heart, feel me in your bones. Just one more night, and I'm coming off this long winding road. I'm on my way, I'm on my way, home sweet home. I'm on my way, I'm on my way, home sweet home.
Goodbye, we'll see you next year!
And leading up to that Queensryche concert at Craig Woods, WAF threw a big contest for local bands. If you want your local band open for Queensryche, send us a CD. Well, 500 discs later, we narrowed it down to three bands. Our three finalists were Dirty Larry, who actually won, and we also had Psycho Sirius and Loose Monkey. Now, we couldn't find Loose Monkey. Dirty Larry's there. Let's go talk with Psycho Sirius.
I guess what I wanted to ask is how you guys feel about being runners-up in the contest we had to open for Queensryche.
I feel really good about it. It's a great contest, and, you know, it was good to come that close, and I think it's good to get the recognition, you know, and, you know, they're definitely going to give us a little attention now.
I'd say a little more than just a little attention.
Well, we gained a lot of respect for the band, too, having, you know, supporting local music. It's really admirable.
I feel a lot like these guys.
Yeah.
Exactly like they do.
Kind of
okay, well, there you have it. Live from, where are we, Mansfield?
Mansfield, Mass.
Psycho Sirius, I'm Dave Lee, out of here.
I got the
Guys, it has been great to be with you this morning.
Oh,
thanks
great having
for
you.
Filling in with me and helping me get through the day. And to all you listeners out there, thanks for putting up with me. Please don't permanently tune out the Greg Hill Show just because today might have been a tad subpar.
You were great, Joe. And before you leave, you know that now that we're good friends and everything, I just like to let you know it's Brookline Savings, and my bank card number is 580 if you just want to make the deposit.
Just transfer the money.
Yeah,
right? I will tell you a quick story, if you've got about 30 seconds
sure.
here, about how a winning of the lottery can turn into a nightmare. There was a guy who hit the lottery recently, gets in a cab, he hit for $4,400. So he thinks he's going to kind of cut a corner. He says to the cab driver, "You go in and collect the money for me because you're in a better tax bracket than I am. You'll pay less when you fill out your social security number and everything else, and then I'll give you a couple $100 for running the errand." Cab driver says, "Fine, I'll go in and do it." Fills out the paperwork. They give him, instead of $4,400, they give him $400. He comes out with a check for $400, and the guy says, "What is this?" He said, "Oh, I owed $4,000 in child support. They deducted it." Don't try to scam your friendly lottery agency.
How did you find that out? The guy came back in and tried to get
his
money?
He was livid. He came back in and said, "What is going on here?" Of course, he didn't have a leg to stand on that.
Wow.
Now, there's a good guy to get to know, Joe Malone, the state treasurer, and soon to be governor, maybe. He's the money man. Well, thanks to Joe Malone, and thanks to you for watching another edition of WAS Real Rock Television. My name is John Osterlin. We'll catch you in the Ozone, and we're going to take you out with Mighty Joe Plum, live from Guitar Center in Natick. It's WAS Real Rock Television.
Sweater, the body covers me. Can you, my darling, can you picture this dreaming in California? Ocean of violets and blue. And the sanction is poses. If you're the heat, the heat's with me. And you're happy just